beautiful song that was Another Angel Around the Throne Tonight. We are going to play a couple of, or play a video of some of the pictures of her life, and we'd like you to enjoy that. But before we do, on behalf of the family, I just want to thank so many of the family members. You know, you came a long ways, and man, we really appreciate you being here, and co-workers. And we know that, you know, some of you already expressed how much you loved Matilda, what she meant to you. Some of you expressed that she was a family favorite to many of you. So we're so thankful that you're here, and we want you to enjoy these pictures, remember her, and we just thank you for being here, okay? introduce myself when I first got up here, but I'm Larry Russell, and I've been a family friend for a long time. And I've known Chris since he was about 4 years old. So I've known, I knew Matilda and Annika since they came here from New Mexico. And I knew Matilda by the name Maddie, because that's the way the, you know, most of her family, I think, remembered her. But I mean, most of her family talked about her, called her, I should say. But anyway, I want to say that I'm so honored to be here to just share in everything that, you know, just to honor her in her life. And so I want to start out with reading here. It says, today we celebrate the life of Matilda Jean Zia, who passed away on Sunday, November the 14th, 2021, at the age of 46. Maddie was a loving wife to Christopher Lewis and a loving mother to Nanaba Akia. Maddie grew up in the Navajo Nation. As a child, she would learn to play the piano and help her grandmother at her sheep camp while singing Amazing Grace. Maddie loved to sing, so much so that in high school she joined the choir, where they competed throughout the United States. Her favorite competition was held in California. When she graduated, she pursued a college degree, but she put it on hold to have her daughter, Nanaba. She later started a career as a law enforcement emergency dispatcher, where she worked for San Juan County for several years until her position with it, until 2005, when they moved to Albuquerque, New Mexico. There, she received a position with the Albuquerque Police Department as a dispatcher. That same year, she met her husband, Christopher Lewis. In 2012, they all moved to Canyon City, Colorado, and she took a position with the Department of Human Services as a child welfare intake screener, which allowed her to be home for her family. She spent this time enjoying cooking, gardening, and working on the new family home. She also enjoyed taking day trips to the mountains with her husband, daughter, and fur babies. Maddie's personality was always optimistic. It was bright. She had a bright outlook on life. Her contagious smile, and it will be missed by her family. That was the one thing I took away from those pictures. The smile that she had was just incredible. That's the way I remember her so much. But she is survived by her husband, Christopher Lewis, daughter Nanaba Akia, father Sammy Akia, sisters Rachel Silvers and Sammy Akia, brother Christopher Akia, mother and father-in-law Kathy and James Davis, and two sisters-in-law, Jamie and Randy Davis. And she has a numerous amount of family here too that came, and we really appreciate you coming. Many of you know that Maddie spent some time in the hospital fighting COVID. And over the past 2 years, we have seen so many people hospitalized with COVID and had to be there without their families. One of the hardest things I think that is for a family, to have a family member in the hospital and not be able to go see them. I know that's hard. And you know, we often think, and I've heard so many people say, man, how hard would that be to be in a hospital, you know, and not have your family there? That would be heartbreaking. But Chris and Maddie were able to communicate by text messages. And the last few days of her life, she told Chris how she felt the Lord. She she felt the Lord holding her hand, and she had overwhelming peace and a calmness, she said. And she felt even healed on the inside. She was just had an overwhelming sense of the Lord's presence in her room. Because the Bible says that the Lord will never leave us nor forsake us. So I'm going to read the scripture in Psalms, the very last part of Psalm 23, verses 4 through 6. It says, "Even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You have anointed my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." And that is something that we can just take away, you know, today, that we think sometimes people are alone, but she was never alone. The Lord knew where she was at. The Lord's there with her. She felt the presence of God, and that is a great comfort for all of us, right? As family members, it's a great comfort. And 2 days before she died, on November the 12th, she posted this on Facebook. It says, "Life is short. Don't take one day for granted. Everything can change in a moment. Be grateful for all you have and all that you are. Remember who is most important to you and always cherish them. Life is a gift and we are blessed." And I really think that, you know, during that time she just knew how important it was, you know, for us to remember our friends that we have, our family, our close relationships, and never take them for granted. And in our time of grieving, you know, just the way we grieve for our loved ones that's gone on before us, you know, in that time, I think their desire is for us to remember them the way that video portrayed her. I don't think they want us to feel sorry or mope or cry, but they want us to feel the love that she has for us. And Maddie loved every one of you, you know. You could tell that just when she came into your presence, you knew that she really took the time to enjoy you. And so, you know, Philippians 4:8 in the Bible says, "Whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, and whatever is good report, if there is any excellence and anything worthy of praise, let your mind dwell on these things." And I think that's what, in a grieving time, that we need to just immediately just think on the blessings that Matilda, Maddie had for all of us. You know, the joy that we spent in her presence. It was just an honor to hear some of her relatives speaking how they felt of her. She meant a lot to everybody. She was just an awesome person. And, you know, just as the Lord gave her a sense of peace and calmness, the Lord is able to comfort us, you know, as we remember Maddie. God is able to comfort us. As Scripture says in 2 Corinthians 1:3-4, it says, Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our afflictions, so that we may be able to comfort those who are in affliction with the comfort by which we ourselves are comforted. You know, it's just awesome to know that God can comfort us, isn't it? It's a beautiful thing, knowing that God is able. And during this time of, you know, missing our loved one, that God is able to comfort us. I want to pray for us. Father, I just, I thank you so much that you are comforting us even right now. I thank you for the friends and family, Lord. You're going to put your arms around them. You're going to surround them with your presence. You're going to bring these memories, Father, to them. And they are going to just be in a place of joy, remembering Matilda and what she did for them, Father. The life she lived in front of them, Father. We thank you for your ability to just watch over us, Father, and keep us in your hand, Father. We thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now we're going to listen to a couple of more songs, and then we're going to have a Navajo blessing. So I just want to thank you for being here.
one of Matilda's aunts from her maternal side, obviously. He gave all his five babies. The prayer that's going to be said for my niece Matilda is requested on behalf of Monica. It's also requested by Monica that prayer is done all in Navajo and that it will not be translated into the English language.
Now I'll pray.
generous. We appreciate that. Thank you.
This does conclude the service, but again, you're all invited to share more memories of the family and the reception.